So today we removed the oil pump module from the 2-liter TFSC engine. Bye bye. So that's the oil pump module which you have in the oil pan. I have explained already in the former videos, like the main bearing girdle, about the negative points or why the people want to get rid of this and remove this. Just have a look in the other videos so you are updated as well. But now we just remove it and I show you what we can do now. So we want to install the pump from 1.8 turbo engine. That's a special pump, it's not a stock pump. I explained this also in the other video, so have a look into this video as well. Basically, the block already has the bushes here and here, so this we can fit in the stock location. We don't need to make any changes. This is to align the pump so it cannot move too much in this direction for the chain. I recommend to if you this bushes they are recently they are made of plastic, they get lost very quick, so best to put some grease inside the hole and so they are fixed and they don't get loose. This area is also very important because here is the oil pressure coming from the oil pump into the engine and the head and so on, so it's very important to have this area clean and not scratched or whatever. As you see, we have three fixing positions, three bolts. So normally it's one bolt here, and one is here. And on this hole, we have to make a special machining, or we have to make a thread. But the tricky thing, I'll make some light. You can see it's an oil channel, which is going underneath to the main oil gallery. So where you have the oil squirters, and then it's the oil is distributed to the main bearings and so on. So this channel is very important. So if you make a grinding here or machining here, or you make a thread inside, the chips and the debris, they will fall down. So we have to clean this. It's very important. Otherwise you can damage the engine, the pistons, the nozzles. If you have debris or any chips inside this channel, you are dead. Yeah. So also have a look on the, I made a video about cleaning the engine block. You have the channel here. This is the channel, which is going through the engine on the other side. And you can clean this with air brake cleaner, and we have a special kit for this to clean it also. You have a look into this video as well. And also maybe look the video for the main bearing girdle, where we explained also about the here the crank, the caps, or where is the difference in the block, and where you when you need to reinforce the block with a main bearing girdle. That's a separate video. And we are very lucky because we have a car now here on the lift, and I can show you how you can install this also when the engine is not taken out. Some people maybe have want to get rid of this module because it's damaged, and then they don't want to remove the engine completely, as we have now. So we show you also how you can do this on the car. So the module is off, and I recommend to take the pump first and make a dry fit to see where we want to go or where we want to be. That's the oil channel. This area needs to be flat completely. If there is any gap, you will lose the oil. It's spreading around there and you will damage the engine as well. And also here about the bushing, which I told you before. Here, for example, the bush is still inside. So this you need to remove. Otherwise, you have a collision and then you see it doesn't fit properly. But what I want to show is here is the hole as well where we have to make thread. I marked this with a special edding. It's a special one here. I like this very much. This is why we want to sell this also in the shop. You can buy it in the shop as well because it's very steady also on oily surface. It's really like paint in different colors. So what you need to do here is to make the thread, a new thread. And then the cleaning is not so difficult because the chips and all the debris will fall down. Yeah. Because we live on planet Earth, everything is falling down. Yeah. I recommend also to clean this later on with this kind of brush, which we also have, just to make sure everything is outside. Don't put any compressed air or something inside because then the chips will come up. And last but not least, I would also recommend to use this one. And then you go just inside and clean it. And basically that's it. That's the, and now we go back to the engine. I'll show you more on the engine. So back to the block. Now we check the oil filter housing, or we have to replace this complete unit. That's the OEM unit, the stock one, which is sticking to the block here. So that's the venting, the block venting, which is connected to the head. So it vents to the head and then to the turbo. And this is the OEM water cooler, they call it water oil cooler, which we also replace with our cooling unit, if you stay with this, of course. Then we have the connection here for the sensor, for the oil pressure sensor, and that's the oil filter itself. And then on the other side, you see all these channels here. Take a look yourself. If you, for example, I have marked this area here. Here you see this is where the oil is coming from the oil pump, which is not filtered yet. So it's coming along here, it's going inside that, going through the oil filter, and then it's distributed to the block, which is, this is the block here, the block area, so the crankshaft and the oil nozzles and the bearings on the crank. And this is the channel which goes up to the head, which is coming out there. You can have a look. You can take a lamp, put some light inside, then you can check also where the oil is going through, where are the roots, and also you can check if it's clean, because it's important to have these channels clean, of course. So this we get rid of. And basically each engine will have this. So each combustion engine must have an oil filter, which is external, even Formula One engines, because you want to reach this filter, you want to remove it, replace it during the service. So each engine will have kind of this kind of plate and an external filter. What we want to do now, we want to install, because we have a 1.8T oil pump, which is of course a race version, not the stock one, we need to use also the 1.8T oil filter housing. Perfect word. And we have to use it because of the oil pressure valve, which is here. This is the oil pressure valve. You can open this one and you can have a look. But you can also have a look from the other side. So you will see a spring and then you see a valve. So this is controlling the oil pressure. Because when the pressure is working against the spring, and once the spring has a preload, of course, and when this preload is reached, it will open into a bypass. So like this, this is the most simple way of controlling any kind of pressure by a spring, basically. And we need this. Also here you can see, this is also very important. This is a check valve for the head. So the oil pressure is going inside the head, going through this channel here. There is a check valve, so the oil pressure is not dropping. So if you stop the engine and it's standing there for 2 weeks or whatever, the pressure from the head will not drop. So it's important when you start the engine again, you will have still the oil in the head and don't need to build up the pressure and the flow first, because then you will damage the head, the camshaft and so on. So this we want to fit. But we need an adapter plate. So basically here is a gasket, a rubber gasket inside. We have a channel which is coming out. Here is the oil, external oil. You can put something inside, but normally we just close that. And you have the water channel. This we will use, but I'll show you now. So that's the, we put on the gasket and then it's adapting to the 1.82 flange. So this will sit like that, basically, with the rubber gasket. And then we put this one on. Of course, you need to put the gaskets on, but I will not install the gasket now, because it's easier for me to fix it like this without gaskets. So and we put like that. So we just hand tight. Should be okay already. So on the top, the black part which you see, it's the snorkel, we call it snorkel. It's adapting to the OEM piping to vent the block. So you can connect your OEM pipe here, the plastic one. Just have a look if it's not broken. Sometimes they get weak because it's plastic, and then they break or they start to leak, the pipe itself. Here is the oil pressure adapter sensor. So we are lucky because it's the same tread. In general, Volkswagen, Audi, they are using M10x1 treads, so it's very easy to put the OEM sensor here. We have one plug here. This is normally on the Mark IV Golf. It's for the oil feed to the turbo. You can just tie this up. And this is another thread, same as this one, M10x1. So you can just close that, and that's fine. So next step, I recommend to install the water oil heat exchanger. You can simply put it like that. There is this big nut, this one here. So you can just tight this up. Not too tight, because then you will compress this part. Basically, what this part, you don't have to install this. You can also remove that, but then you have to shorten the pipe. But I recommend to use it, because especially in winter time, it helps a lot to heat up the engine. Because the water is always getting quicker warm than the oil. And with this part installed, it's much quicker to get on the right temperature to run the engine. And this is also important for the catalytic converter, because this will only work when you have lambda 1. And in general, when the engine is cold, you have lambda like 0.8, 0.9, so on the rich side, and then the cut is not working properly. And of course, we want to get the engine on temperature as quick as we want to push it. Yeah. Push. So then we have here this adapter, which we put inside the water. Now I made a mistake, because normally you have to install this first, so because otherwise you cannot turn it inside. So make sure you put this inside first. And then we have this bolt here, the push-on fitting. So you have this like that. And then you just connect the water hose with our adapter here. That's just an example hose like this. So the water can go out here, go inside the adapter, and then here you just connect your stock piping, which is here on the engine bay now. And last but not least, for summertime, I recommend to use our oil cooler. Well, we have developed a hexagon inside, because it's much easier to tight this up. And we have the dash fitting now, dash 8. It's of course with thermostat. And if you would like, you can install our oil temperature sensor here. So we have to install it with the rubber on top. Rubber first, and then the bolt. Okay, like this. And I have my special snap-on tool, 12 millimeter socket. It's tight. And last but not least, don't forget the oil filter. It's the short version. I recommend to put in some fresh oil already inside now. Just lubricate a bit of the gasket, same as the gasket there. Then you put it on, that's it. It's done. So, and last but not least, depending on the car which you have, but in general, space is limited in this area. So the pipe which is going to the throttle body, to the manifold, you have to make it on your own, because it will not suit this solution. Or you can buy also our pipe, which we have. We have developed an aluminium pipe, a high boost pipe, and this will suit in any car and any engine. Okay, take care and have fun. Bye.